So let me guess, you were out on a ride or went to crank your sled and the damn check engine light started flashing. Don't stress, just count how many times it blinks and let's talk about it.
I'd like to welcome you if you're new to the channel. I'm Danny with Escape Power Sports and today we'll be doing a basic maintenance and repair video series for your Polaris two-stroke snowmobile. So my first ride on this Rmk 900 was going freaking awesome until the damn check engine light started flashing. And here's what I learned about the check engine lights on Polaris snowmobiles.
So apparently we don't need a fancy computer tool. We just need to count how many times the light flashes, as it will correspond with a specific issue. And after not finding anything on how to diagnose this light in the owner's manual, I started calling around and compiled the info in this chart from a variety of threads and forums. And as you can see here, how many times the light blinks corresponds to different potential issues with a variety of systems and sensors on the sled. If you'd like, feel free to pause the video on any of the following charts for more specific information on whatever issue you're having. I found these helpful charts on a forum called SnowWest. And as soon as I saw these, I signed up for this free form, as it seemed to have tons of helpful threads for people like myself who are new to snowmobiling, but eager to learn. On a side note, if you find any of the information in this video helpful, do me a quick favor and give this video a thumbs up so I'll know I'm on the right track here. But anyway, my check engine light was blinking 5 times, so I knew I was probably dealing with a failed EGT sensor, and I was delighted to learn it would be a very easy job. But of course, before spending the cash on a new sensor, it definitely don't hurt to check that it's screwed in tight and that all the wires appear to be plugged in and free of any cuts or heat damage. Mine was tight and the wires looked good, so I decided it was time to replace this exhaust gas temperature sensor. And the only tool required for this easy one beer job would be an adjustable crescent wrench of your size preference. And this easy job starts by simply unplugging the bullet connectors coming from the sensor. And something worth mentioning about these connectors is I found in my research that they're notorious for breaking behind the insulation, leading to needless replacements of functioning sensors. Mine appear to be in great condition, but I'm sure there's some kind of way to double confirm these connectors are good with a multimeter. But that fancy tool is still a little over my head, so if you have the know-how or experience for additional diagnostics with a multimeter, please share it with all of us in the comments below. Because I would just love for these videos to become a place for open discussion and group problem solving for some common issues. Anyway, as you can see, after unplugging these connectors, removing the sensor is as simple as unthreading it with a crescent wrench.
So I read somewhere online that this $30 AC Delco exhaust gas temperature sensor out of a Silverado fits some of these machines, and I didn't get halfway through reading that before I had one of these ordered. But unfortunately, after doing some additional reading up on it, that cheap workaround is only going to work on a handful of Arctic Cats around the same year model. And sure enough, when the AC Delco came in, it was too big to fit in the hole, and the threads are actually a different size and pitch, which is definitely kind of a bummer because I love finding ways like that to save y'all some cash, especially when a new sensor from Polaris is over 160 bucks. But life goes on, and I did find this still functioning used EGT sensor off of eBay for less than half that. So let's slap it in there and see how she does.
But first, eBay also had a used solution for this ass-chewing eyesore of a seat. I then proceeded to thread in our new, used EGT sensor and plug in the connectors. And I was told by a handful of Polaris service departments that they think the check engine code will clear itself on startup if replacing the sensor fixed the problem. And sure enough, when I cranked it up, the check engine light was off.
Well, hell yeah, looky there.
And we won't know for sure until I can put some serious miles on the sled. But after putting it around a neighbor's field at around 80 miles an hour, the sled is pulling strong again and running smooth.
So moving out here to the mountains from Louisiana and building this little shop, I'm very new to snowmobiling. Hell, I'm new to mechanic work in general. So if you have anything to add about what we talked about here today, or any thoughts, experience, expertise, anything like that, please share it in the comments below, and you can bet I'll keep making these how-to videos as we get in more machines and as I learn. And if you found any of this check engine information for your Polaris snowmobile helpful, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel and check out the rest of the videos coming out in this series for the maintenance for these sleds. Should be covering a wide variety of topics, anything from fluids to belts to plugs, you can expect it. I'm Danny with Escape Power Sports. I really want to thank y'all for watching, and until next time, we'll see y'all on the trails. A basic maintenance and repair video series for your two-stroke Polaris snowmobile.